Most people, when they think of air pollution, they think of factories or power plants. And when we're driving our car, there's a lot of pollution that's emitted from our tailpipe. Poor air quality can reduce lung function up to 20%, but air pollution can also pose a problem for the Chesapeake Bay and its waterways. The most prevalent pollutant that enters into the bay from the air is nitrogen. Nitrogen is produced whenever there's a burning of a fossil fuel, and when this nitrogen gets into the air, it can either just fall out naturally in a process known as dry deposition, or it can also wash out of the atmosphere through precipitation or rainfall. The Chesapeake Bay estuary is the largest estuary in the United States, and this is composed of a watershed that's made up of all the streams and rivers that flow into it, and any nitrogen that enters into that watershed area ultimately drains into the bay. Up to a third of the nitrogen comes from the atmosphere, the much larger airshed. An airshed is the region that influences the air quality in that area. Excess of nitrogen entering into the bay can lead to algae blooms. When that algae starts to decompose, it actually uses up the oxygen in the water and creating dead zones throughout the bay. There's so many activities out there that not only make an improvement for the air quality, but also can make a broader environmental impact, especially on the Chesapeake Bay. In general, people just conserving energy and reducing the amount of waste that they produce can have huge results in the terms of our air quality and our water quality.